right. Welcome to the Sci-Fi Express Lane. This is Jeff Carroll. Today is kind of a review of Madam Web or reaction, but not to the movie itself. It's to kind of the backlash that the movie has created, right? And I'm going to title it Madam Web, the most comic book. What comic book movies, what we ask for with comic book movies, I think that might be a good title. I don't know. Sometimes I change them after I post it. But why I wanted to name it that is because there's been backlash. Oh, this is the worst comic book movie that I've ever seen. Then you got guys getting caught masturbating in the movie. And then you're like, how can it be that bad if dudes is masturbating to it, right? You're like, all right, I understand what masturbation is, but God dang, that's some type of positive reaction. I mean, I don't want it to be porn, but golly, it can't be that bad. So I went to see it, and I wanted to see this train wreck for myself. And what I've came away with is every movie requires magic. And what we call magic is the ability for the movie to get the audience to believe it, all right, to buy into it. And there's agreements. One, it's got to make sense. One, two, you know, that's the story. It's got to make sense. Three, you create a universe and you follow the rules that you created. Can't change rules. Can't do all this other wild stuff. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, and I guess some of the other things are, you know, realism. You know what I'm saying? And not realism within the rules of the story, but just realism in the rules of physics and reality. You know, I remember somebody got upset with, I think it was at the time of True Blood and Underworld was out, with people having werewolves that transformed into different sizes of mass. Okay, so you take something like the American Werewolf in London. He turned into a werewolf that was practically the same body mass as he was. But then when you looked at Underworld, the werewolves got bigger, right? When you looked at True Blood, the werewolves turned into wolves. And not human-sized wolves. I mean, smaller wolves, like dogs. And it just freaked them out. And what causes people to freak out is they don't buy into the universe. Both movies were consistent, but it was a pet peeve of somebody who, you know, get hung up on physics. You know what I'm saying? Take, for instance, the bullet that Angelina Jolie teaches dude how to bend, right? There's no bending of the bullet. It's just that they make it curve, and they really had to sell that. Because if you didn't buy into it, it was, you know, you wouldn't be able to enjoy the story. So Madam Web is that. But the other thing is why I say it's like the most comic book movie, or what comic book movies ask for, is that people go into these comic book movies with unexpected realness expectations. And you have to, it's like Madam Web is holding a mirror up to the comic book industry, because you can't have a Wonder Woman running around in panties and boots and think that's a legitimate battle outfit. You understand? That has to be something, you know, that it works for the market, because it's guys who want to see legs, big boobies swinging around without a support bra. You know what I'm saying? Just unrealistic. Yo, we see MMA fighters every day. They don't look like IG models. And that's just reality. Now, Jade Cargill, okay, she's in WWE or whatever that is now. I forgot the name. She's a has some amazing body dimensions. And there have been some other WWE wrestlers, but that's not real. They're not mixing it up in, you know, the octagon in MMA fights or boxing. You know what I'm saying? So what's the real reality of those body dimensions being real fighting dimensions? You know what I'm saying? For all intents and purposes, the men just need to look physically fit. You know, because Bruce Lee was an unassuming sculptured body. You couldn't tell he was sculptured with his clothes on. So he could have been Daredevil. He could be Wolverine, you know. Superman don't even need muscles. He's extraterrestrial. And then they cover their bodies. You understand? Now, I think even pajamas or leotards or whatever they wear is sort of extra too. You know, but that's comic books, man. We buy into that. What I liked about the X-Men, or what we did with the X-Men, is they desexualized the women. Because these comics are drawn by men, mostly, and for a male audience, mostly. And if it's not a male that's buying it, sometimes women sexualize other women to live vicariously through them as well. You know what I'm saying? And I think that is the biggest thing with manga. You know what I'm saying? You'll see all of these sexualized women and energies. And, I mean, the guys in manga don't even look like that. I mean, unless you're just getting off on hair and eyes, but their bodies don't look extra sculptured. It's the women. And then, you know, talking about the sexualization, right? It goes all the way to the cosplayers. You know, cosplayers, women. Ain't nobody holding no gun to these women's head to walk around with bikini, damn near thong. Some of them can't even wear underwear to kind of portray the characters correctly. And these are supposed to be battle characters. So anyway, there was more to Madame Web, right? Madame Web had homegirl that I... was from 50 Shades of Grey as a star. Now, mind you, I need cliff notes because there's a variety of tastes of beauty, and you know, the slim body that she possesses is, you know, big boobies or whatever they are, that's not my type. I don't say that they're not attractive. Like, give you an example. Like Taylor Swift, she may be attractive, like overly attractive to some people. And to me, I'll just say she's really got a nice face. She's got a pretty face, you know, and that's it. But, you know, when you look at Madame Web, what could make a guy masturbate in it? Well, he's turned on by the women in the movie. And I think they brought in women that are... some men's fantasies. The one little girl, I forgot, her mouth formed an O. I can't do it, right? An O, right? She full lips, white girl. She did a whole bunch of close-ups on her. And I'm in the back of my mind, I went to the movie to study the movie, you know, and it wasn't bad. It wasn't horrible. It was not the worst movie that I've seen before. It had True Lies got on my nerves more. In the same way that people might not like Madame Web, True Lies got on my nerves. But the other girl that played a mother, right? She's from American Horror Story, or looks like the girl from American Horror Story. Another pretty face, full lip girl that they did a bunch of close ups on, and. The girls, the girl from Sicario, the little girl, she grown up now. She was, you know, playing a sexual energy. There's a sexual energy to her. And I guess, you know, you could act like you ignore it or whatever, but it's there. And they put all these girls together and they're acting stupid. I mean, let's say they're acting ditzy, right? And it's not, it could get on some people's nerves, but this is the stuff they do in comic books. This is what they do. This is why I read Blade Runner, Planet of the Apes, Killadelphia, because I don't read, you know, the Madam Webbs, you know. But pick up a Vampirella, right? Pick up a Vampirella. Pick up a Red Sonja. Pick up a Lady Death. Hackslash. You know what I'm saying? I don't think Hackslash. I think maybe for a different reason. But pick up what's in the morning manga? Sailor Moon. They act dizzy. So there's a scene in Madam Web that's in the trailer, so I don't have no problem. One of the girls gets up on the table. They see a group of boys. Oh, let's go talk to the boys. I've never heard that in real life. They go over, it look like they're football boys, and they start dancing. Now, if they wanted to juice them, like in the movie with Cardi B and Jennifer Lopez, where they was scheming, yeah, they would do their feminine ways to get them. But they weren't. They were just doing this for fun. So one girl pulls the other girl up on stage. And Britney Spears' song Toxic is playing, and it's a new song in the story. And then the third girl gets pulled up on there. And now they're all dancing for the boys and just laughing. It goes nowhere. I don't even know what the scene is for, right? Yes, that's what happens in comic books. Don't sleep. Go read some of these comic books. They are very shallow, right? They're incomplete scenes. I wonder, you know, I love the writers and I respect the writers, but I think this is why some people may not respect all of the writers, right? Because they do things like this. You know, I don't know if it's the editors cut down the scene or whatever. I didn't make Madam Web. Somebody that makes more money than me made it. Somebody, there's a logic behind it, and they've made it fly. I want to know, did they watch their own movie? Because I would pause it and be like, wait a minute. Somebody was saying that they should have brought Mystery Science Theater back. Exactly. Because you could make comments throughout Madam Web. I actually wanted to call it Madam B Movie Web. Because that's the way I would enjoy it. It's like in the early part of the scene, early part of the movie, the first scene, I was clapping out of laughter, and nobody else clapped, so I stopped clapping because I was like, "This is hilariously, not brilliant, but beautiful." It did it. They pulled it off. It just looked funny to me. And some people, they don't laugh at movies because we've been given these real Iron Man, real Captain America-ish movies in Marvel so much, to see them do something that's like True Lies. I also felt like it was like Laura Croft. And I was telling my wife, you don't have to be naked for men to sexualize over you or for people, right? Laura Croft was sexualized from her video game. That's why they went and got Angelina Jolie to play Laura Croft. Angelina Jolie was a sex symbol. It's the same casting in Madam Web. And I don't even know this girl's name, but I'm pretty sure, just like that little girl that was in Thor, that is in Two Broke Chicks or whatever it is. I can't remember. She's a sex symbol. And I didn't know that. Denning, whatever her name is. And I don't think she's unattractive, but she's not, you know, high up on my list so much I don't even know her name. Give me, Scarlett Johansson. I'll take her. Shoot, the other girl. And there's been a lot of beautiful women in the Marvel movies. But, yeah, these women are low-key sex symbols. They've got a lot of following. They tear up the red carpet, whatever, these guys' dreams. I don't think they have OnlyFans, but they may have a lot of pictures on IG. So this girl is an Angelina Jolie. She brings a lot with her to the role. So, I don't know. I said just about everything. I'll just say this. From the clothes to some of the scenes, like, there's a scene in there that reminded me of Captain Marvel. right? And Captain Marvel got hated on also, but I think that's because of the feminine energy. And Captain Marvel is a woman beating up men. All right, so I get that. You know, I don't agree with it, but I get it, right? In this movie, in Captain Marvel, there was a scene where Nick Fury, Samuel Jackson's character, loses his eye, right? And it was a tie-in, it was an Easter egg, and we let it slide, but the scene was corny, and it was just, he's sitting there talking to the cat, and the cat scratches his eye out. That was it. It served no other purpose except to explain why his eye was scratched. There's a lot of scenes like that, or feel like that, in Madame Web. Even how Madame Web loses her sight, even that. But there's a lot of other scenes in there, and if that distracts you from enjoying a movie, then yeah, if you want to hate on it, like, immediately, and I'm just going to go over a little bit longer, but immediately after the Madame Web hate came out, I accepted that it was definitely because of people upset with all of the hate that DC gets. Madame Web still, to me, is better than a bunch of DC movies. I'm sorry, because, you know, it doesn't get on my nerves as much. And I like Marvel trying to do I Know What You Did Last Summer type movies. That's what this is a mix between I Know What You Did Last Summer and Lara Croft. And it's a different genre. We can't keep having the same genre. That's why I like The Joker. That's by DC. I like the different genre. Let's go. I like Ant-Man. I like the comedy and the humor. You understand? Let's mix it up. And if they want to go horror movie, fine. They want to go slasher, fine. If we're going to B-movie, fine. Let's do it. All right. That's it. Jeff Carroll, Sci-Fi Express Lane. Like, share, subscribe, and of course comment. I don't care where you comment. Comment on Facebook, comment on Instagram, or comment on my YouTube page itself. All right, deuces.